Self-sufficiency in food production is primary. This is what is actually going to create what is called self-sustainability. Food security is very important for population. And our people have land which is endowed with water. This actually makes it very desirable that our people should not want for food. We have got small-scale agriculture. But what is important is that we want this small-scale agriculture to be sustainable. And that's why this is an issue that requires proper planning. It is important that the county government begins the issue of addressing land security and how we can be able to do some consolidation of land so that we have economies of scale in our country. If you can get economies of scale, you can be able to be self-sufficient in food production, and that will give us independence. This is very important. I'm happy that the county government of Siaya is actually partnering with the farmers here. I've seen fractions for hire, which have been told by the governor have been hired at 2,000 shillings per acre. This will enable our farmers to be able to have bigger farms and plant those bigger farms in time and plant on time. It's very important. I've also seen companies here producing seeds, high quality seeds, which are conducive to the environment around this area. All these have been very, very impressive indeed today. So I want to thank the lady, the young girl, Tabitha, who invited me to come here today. This young lady came to my office and looked for me. And she told me what she was doing, I did not believe. But today I've seen is believing. Congratulations, Tabitha. Congratulations. The issue that I've addressed here, the issue of devolution. Devolution is an idea whose time had come. But there are many people who do not want devolution. Devolution had very many powerful enemies. And we've seen that devolution itself is suffering in the process of implementation. We've seen so many new bills being developed and being taken to parliament with the intention of playing back on devolution. We are saying that this is a process that is unconstitutional and that must be resisted. There are so many new bills which are coming to parliament, and these bills want to take away functions which have already been devolved by the constitution and take them back to the national government. That will not be allowed. That must be resisted strongly. Secondly, we would like to have the national government to ensure that funds which have already been approved by parliament are remitted down to the county government so that they can be used for the purpose of development in the country. Then I also say that they have given a few advice to the government that there are functions which we have centralized before, like in terms of infrastructure, the roads, Kura and Kera existed at that time because we were dealing with a unitary system of government. Today, Kura and Kera should actually fall under the county government. And those funds should be transferred to the counties so that counties can use those funds for development of roads and infrastructure in the counties. This will make the work easier for the national government. But of course we know there's a resistance, but ultimately this issue will have to be addressed nationally. So finally I'm saying that I'm around, I'm going nowhere. I am here with the people, and the people support my quest to be the chairman of the African Union Commission. I'm thanking them. But when I go to Addis Ababa, I will be very much around here. I'm not going anywhere. I'm going nowhere. And I've told our people that they are unbearable. And they are unconquerable. Thank you very much.